Okay, in the previous example, we illustrated how the probability of staying at the initial state decays without evidence. Let's now incorporate evidence to improve our inference of latent states. The quantity we want to calculate here is the posterior probability of xt given all the data points observed so far. And this can be computed recursively using the posterior at the previous time, as shown here. Derived from Bayes' rule and Markov property, to calculate this quantity, we first make a prediction using all previous data points, up to t minus 1. This is the same form as the equation in exercise 2, actually, except we replace the predictive probability by the posterior probability after using evidence. Then we can just multiply our prediction probability with the likelihood of new data point and normalize over all discrete states. Okay, let's now consider the same example mentioned in exercise 2 and see if we can compensate the exponential decay by combining data. In order to do this, in this exercise, we will freeze the true state sequence to be all zero and generate noisy measurements from it, then infer the states given these noisy measurements. You will implement this example in exercise 3. In terms of programming, you will calculate the predictive probability given past data by a one-step Markov transition. You then will need to calculate the likelihood of observing new data point, and the posterior is the combination of these two. After that, you will run multiple simulations using different randomly generated measurement sequences and plot the average posterior probability of staying at zero over time. We've already provided the code to do so. After finishing this, you should be able to get a plot like this. As you can see, the posterior probability of staying at zero will be close to 1 with low transition rate and small noise. Please try different values of transition rates and noise levels. Observe how that affects the curve. What if you have a high transition rate but low noise? Now let's unfreeze the state sequence and see, for a randomly generated state sequence, is forward inference able to recover it from noisy data? In this exercise, you will generate a random state sequence and corresponding measurements as in exercise 1. Then, use the forward inference function you just completed in last exercise to get the posterior probabilities. You need to finish the code to extract inferred states by choosing the one with higher posterior probability at each time. We've already provided some code to visualize the true state sequence together with the inferred ones, like this. You can see here the inference is making error at around time 41. Please try different switching probabilities and noise levels and see how inference accuracy changes with them. Have fun.